million wasps. It's our database in space and time. It allows us to do research. It allows us to make identifications and verify them. So it's very, very important. So as part of that, we do a lot of collecting and collaborate with individuals that are collecting wasps all over the planet to improve our collection and improve our ability to do research and to make accurate identifications. So there are a variety of techniques that we use to collect parasitic hymenoptera, or hymenoptera in general. The first involves using small bowls, usually yellow or fluorescent yellow, work best, and most hymenoptera are preferentially attracted to yellow, but that's also taxon dependent. So certain hymenopterans may be attracted to fluorescent blue, non-fluorescent blue, few are attracted to white, not much is attracted to red, and in a study that we did to work on this statistically, clear was our control. So basically the effect of water in the habitat where we're collecting. So these are filled with soapy water solution. They're set out in habitats, and you come back and you basically empty them out. They could be set up in transects or underneath a blooming shrub, anything of interest. And you come back after 2 days, and you're basically pouring them all through a brine shrimp net. Once you've emptied your various treatments or transects, you can evert your bolus of parasitic wasps into a Whirlpack bag with a squirt bottle of ethanol. Then you just put your label in there, and then you've got one sample collected via pan trapping. We've got a few other, you know, more generalized techniques that are used on especially the larger hymenopterans. You know, netting them with a net, putting them in a kill jar for some of the larger stinging wasps. That's the best way to do that. Sweep netting is something that we do to collect micro hymenoptera. And this is one of our custom nets. So the head is customized as a triangle. So when we're sweeping, if we're sweeping, say, near the surface of the ground in a grassy habitat, we're not missing anything that we might miss if we had just a rounded net handle. There's more surface area oppressed near the ground. And we're basically just going through and sweeping shrubs, grasses, etc. Our net bag is specially constructed out of silkscreen material. It's very tough and tear resistant. And then at that point, we have a bolus of very active insects in here, and we use a customized aspirator. This one has a long in pipe so that we can reach down into the net. This one doesn't have it, but we also will include a fuel filter here from a Volkswagen, which removes pollen, dust, and other debris from the stream that you're aspirating. So basically plug the aspirator in. We're going to hold the net up so that if this is the sun, we want the sun shining in on the bag near the end. We don't want it shining like this. Otherwise, everything will just fly up towards the sun and out of the bag past your head. So we put our head in. We have the sun shining down on the bag. And we put our aspirator in. And over the years, we've learned to recognize what our particular taxa do. Do they stumble? Do they hop? Do they fly? Do they crawl? Do they play dead? And so we know what to do in terms of waiting for them to collect them. We've learned their tricks. So this is the most fun. You see what you're getting right away in the field. This is something that we bought a couple years ago. Trip. We went down to southern Florida earlier in April. It's a mini fogger. It's designed for home use. You power it up, and this coil heats up via the propane, and it volatilizes the liquid insecticide into a very, very fine particulate mist. It's good for things like a large decaying log that's covered with bryophytes and moss, and you can tell that it's infested with flies and beetles, and they're consuming this decaying wood tissue. Of course, there are going to be parasitic wasps attacking them. Clearly, you're not going to sweep a large decaying wasp with a net. Very inefficient. So what we decided to try is setting up some of our bowl traps, which I mentioned, under the log, power it up, fog it, and then wait. So this has, the insecticide has low mammalian toxicity, which was good for us because we had a couple wind shifts. And we see what falls down into our bowls underneath the log. Another way that we get a little bit more information in terms of how we collect are using rearing containers. Then you set these up with whatever. It's infested seeds, infested twigs, a fruit that has maggots in it. It could be anything. You label it, and you set it up, and you wait. And you come by every day, and you look right here, because they're going to be attracted to this point source of light. So that's good fun. This is all wholesome. Bugs, not drugs.